is what this is all about. And I'm not talking just basic, you know, what to bring for food and this and that type of thing. But there's a big topic out there, guys, that a lot of folks don't understand is survival. And it's called communication. And if I ask each one of you right now the definition of communication, most of you are going to say a radio or a cell phone. And I'll quote that because it's true. But communication has to do with something else. And I'll bring that up on the next go-round here. But, Philip, yeah, jump in there, man, and throw a comment in. I know it's been a while since you and I talked. I had my reasons for backing away from the group, but it is me. It was my reasons for backing away. But anyway, it is what it is. But anyway, I'm glad that you're on board, Philip, and thank you for allowing us to come up here on 7.191, because I know you guys have had a gathering for a long time, but at least let me convey my thank you for allowing us to join on this frequency here to share some education. K4KGP.
We never stopped being brothers, Greg. Thought about you, Rosie, a lot. I had to get a new phone, so Facebook's playing their little game. They even sent me a brand new password and said, use our password, and you won't have any more issues. Well, they won't accept their own password, so I haven't messed with them since. Otherwise, I'd say hello to her once in a while. But, glad to have you on the radio. Good to hear you, brother. I had no hard feelings whatsoever. I figured at one point we'll cross paths again and everything's fine. Just so you know, I have no issues whatsoever. Everybody has certain reasons, and I respect that. And glad to hear you, though. That's the bottom line. Glad to hear you back on the radio. It's good to have a conversation with you. And yeah, the good pink lemonade, that's very valid. That is how the pink lemonade used to get started, and it is good. They told us all those years, don't eat elderberries. Well, or sumac. Sumac will kill you, but they were liars. And I'm glad that somebody's talking about that here today. This is education for me, too. I don't know if you've known, but in the last year or so, I've gotten back into the herbal and holistic stuff again. Let half my yard go back to nature to get some harvest. And the harvest so far this year has been really awesome. Learning about different plants that I have here and what is the most beneficial. And of course, I'm enjoying the dandelion. Those do taste pretty good, and everything about that plant is edible and medicinal. It's amazing what I have growing on this property that I've come across that has a value of either food, medicinal, or both. So I've been doing a lot of that here for this year, and hope to have quite a bit stocked up. In fact, I have quit some prescription medicines and working on the last one. When I get this cayenne pepper start to prove it out here, then I'll be getting off this last medicine too in the future. But had great results. The doctors are baffled, but that's because in 1958 they quit teaching about herbs and holistic medicine, which has been around for 6 centuries. And I like the other formats you're bringing here with the survival tips and so forth. Everybody, like you said, everybody can learn something. And don't be afraid to ask questions. This is good, valuable information. It's honest information, and it's healthy information. And make some notes, people. And if you got questions, please ask these guys. They're more than willing to share their knowledge. And like Ray says, he's been teaching survival, so he has a lot of information for you guys. Just like to go camping. Think you might want to take along one of your camping chairs, okay? But anyway, thank you, brother, and I'm going to sit back and listen. If I get a little goby in me there, I might jump in and do a comment here and there, but I'm just going to enjoy the ride for a little while. It's great to hear all you guys, and I appreciate you guys doing what you're doing. That's why I don't have any problem relinquishing time here for this to happen. It's something that's very necessary for the general public to understand and learn. KD4KIP, back to you guys.
KD4KIP, WBCBAB.
no problem whatsoever. I have no issues with sharing the band with you guys. I want people to be educated. Self-education is the way to go. Good afternoon, Bob. We got a little extra format in here today. Growing and herbal and survival tips and so forth that these guys are going to be running on 2 o'clock, starting on 2 o'clock on Sunday. Really good group of knowledgeable guys, so I hope you hang around and listen to them too. Bob, over. Okay, roger, roger. Good to have you right along. These are a good group of guys here. This is a new format they wanted to start. And you know how 40 meters is to find the clear frequency. And it works good for them, and it works good for me, and I hope everybody else. Like I said, we'll learn a lot of valuable information. And don't be afraid to ask these guys questions. I'm sure if there's a question out there, somebody will be able to answer it for you. So there's a lot to learn here, and I think it's a great format, and I hope it gets a good following too. KD4KIP.
Greg, are you still there? ABAKY Cloud here.
You're right, Cloud. I got a copy on the switch antenna. Sure, yeah, go ahead, Cloud.
Yeah, man, long time no here. How you been doing?
Let me see. About 500 from here, split four ways, greased down, waxed, and sanded. How's that?
Survival training?
Yeah, for many years while I was in the fire department, and also with a group that about 10 years experience with.
Well, a long time ago we had a little thing called Piney Point Bow Hunters Club, and we took some survival training. One thing that we all did just for the heck of it, and just to see, you know, if you could do it. And what we did was find a little bitty tuck tin and a good backpack. And take off like on a Friday midday and go back in the mountains. It can be 500 foot from your home as long as you're in the mountains. Go somewhere, find your nice campsite, have your canteen full of water, and come out on a Sunday. You know, camp Friday night, camp Saturday night, you know, and then Sunday at midday, come back out of the woods. You could take a small pellet rifle with you, a BB rifle with you. You could take even a little 410 shotgun with you, or a 22 with you, if you so desire. But you can take anything with you want to pack. I always get a big pack of beef jerky. Because you might have to eat it in the morning. You might have to eat it in the evening. You never know. But the main thing is try not to break into that bag of beef jerky. And make sure that you carry your lighter, carry your one of them magnesium strips that you can start a fire with, and make sure that you got you a good knife. You know, all the survival tools that you need, a compass, and that knapsack. Make sure you got everything you need that you can survive.